All right, here we are with the Ruggeri cello again. We've got all the top cracks glued. One there on this apple, on that apple. Right here is another one. We had three cracks up here. So now we've prepared some cleats or reinforcement patches. Very lightweight, very thin. About a half a millimeter at the most. And we shave that to make it flat. So actually remove about just as much wood as we put back in, so it won't affect the tone. But without these cleats, these would tend to come apart again. And you can see we still have the cork wedged in there to keep those cracks closed. Now we'll see if our glue is ready, which it appears to be. And if these are properly fit, I'll get that slightly damp there. And we just have these sitting in place right now. Move them out of the way. This wood is very dry, and if we put the glue on there without dampening it first, it'll suck all the glue up. And then the joint will be glue starved, is the expression for that. So now we'll put a drop of glue on there. That's all you need is one drop. It's actually too big of a drop. We'll put another part of it over here. This is very, very tight fit, so jam it out that one in place. We slide it around a little bit and then it creates a vacuum. So it kind of sucks it down. And it also will tell us if there's any unevenness. Wipe away the excess glue with a damp Q-tip. Yeah, that's not moving. And one drop of glue. Just to show you how tight that vacuum is there. We'll attempt to pop one off. Yeah, that one came up pretty easy. Didn't get enough glue on that one. Doesn't slide, then you know it's got a good vacuum. And we have one cleat that's slightly larger because it goes over two cracks. I think I explained that before. But place now. Wiping out the excess glue. Yeah, that one wasn't. You can see if that's going to slide around, that's not a good vacuum. might need a little more glue. This one, because it's a little extra big, maybe not perfectly flat, but we have a clamp ready to put there to secure it. Just a little pressure, don't need much. Yeah, that one's acting a little goofy too, so I think we'll put a clamp on that one as well. There we go. These are almost set up because hot glue dries very quickly. So we'll let it glue dry, and tomorrow we will take our spatula and try and lift them up. If they pop up real quick, easily, then we have to glue them down again. But they shouldn't, because I was careful to make sure they're nice and flat and got plenty of glue on them. Well, there you have it, and we'll seal these up after we're done and color them a little just so they match the rest of the top. There you go.